Friends, watch Rivian bringing a huge wind turbine to power its new electric vehicles. Rivian, the electric vehicle maker, has announced that the final components of its on-site wind turbine have arrived in Normal, Illinois. When the turbine is up and running, every new Rivian electric vehicle that rolls off the assembly line will get its first charge with 100% carbon-free energy. This is a significant step for Rivian, which is committed to operating a net zero plant. The wind turbine is a 2.8 megawatt unit that will be located on the company's campus in Normal, Illinois. It is expected to generate enough electricity to power about 1,000 homes. The turbine is expected to be operational by the end of the year, probably sooner from what we see from this video. Rivian's decision to install a wind turbine is part of its broader commitment to sustainability. The company has also committed to using 100% renewable energy for its charging network and to offsetting all of its emissions. Rivian's commitment to sustainability is a friend's positive step for the environment. It is also a good sign for the future of electric vehicles. As more and more automakers transition to electric vehicles, it is important that they do so in a way that is sustainable. Rivian is setting a good example with Tesla and some other car companies for other automakers to follow. Here is what Rivian said in its tweet as you are seeing this video. The final components of Ford Rivian's on-site wind turbine arrived in Normal. When the turbine is up and running, every new Rivian vehicle that rolls off our assembly line will get its first charge with 100% carbon-free energy, contributing to our goal of operating a net zero plant. So I honestly don't know how long will it take until Rivian has this wind turbine up and running. Some people say by the end of the year, others say this may take just a month or few months, I don't know. But here are some additional facts about Rivian's wind turbines in general. The turbine is expected to generate about 10 million kilowatt hours of electricity per year. The turbine is expected to offset about 10,000 metric tons of carbon dioxide emissions per year. And this will probably save Rivian a lot of money. Rivian wind turbine is a significant step forward for the company and for the environment. It is a sign that Rivian is committed to sustainability and to make a positive impact on the planet. So what do you think? Do you think other companies like Tesla should also have their own wind turbines and power their electric cars from 100% renewable energy source like wind or even solar? Let me know, friends, your thoughts in the comment section below. Tesla Twitter blogger Sawyer Merritt today has shared a rare video of Pepsi Tesla semi delivering Pepsi products on what appears to be a California highway, friends. The video quickly went viral with many people commenting on the sight of the electric truck. In this video, the Pepsi Tesla semi can be seen driving down a highway with a trailer full of Pepsi products, I assume, or it may be returning, maybe empty, I don't know. The truck is painted white with the Pepsi logo on the side. The video shows the truck driving past other cars and trucks on the highway. Merritt's tweet has been liked over 4,000 times and retweeted over 300 times. This is going viral. Many people have commented on the video expressing their excitement about seeing the Pepsi Tesla semi. One user commented, "This is so cool. I can't wait to see more of these trucks on the road." Another user said, "This is a big step for Tesla and Ford, this is a big step for Tesla and for the future of transportation. The Pepsi Tesla semi is part of a fleet of 100 Tesla semi that PepsiCo ordered in 2017. The trucks are expected to be used for local and long distance deliveries. PepsiCo is not the only company that has ordered Tesla semi. Other companies that have placed orders for the trucks include Walmart, FedEx, and J.B. Hunt. The Tesla semi is an all-electric truck that has a range of up to 500 miles on a single charge. The truck can tow up to 80,000 pounds and has a top speed of 60 miles per hour, from what I understand. Now, the Tesla semi is expected to start to shipping more customers in 2023. Here are some of the important comments that people have made about this video at the Pepsi Semi, Tesla Semi. "This is a big step," says one person, "for Tesla and for the future of transportation." Another one said, "I can't wait to see more of these trucks on the road. This is so cool. I'm excited to see how these trucks perform." Yet another person comments saying, "I'm glad to see the PepsiCo is committed to sustainability." And another person says, "This is a great way of reducing emissions and improve air quality." What I comment is this: what will happen to our jobs if all of these trucks and robots take over? What do you think? Do you have any comments on that? Anyway, the comments on the video show that people are excited about the future of electric transportation. The Pepsi Tesla Semi is a sign that future of transportation is, I think, going to be electric, and I would say solar electric, and it is a welcome step toward a more sustainable future. Let me know your thoughts, friends. What do you think about this video? Tesla is good at finding loopholes and using them, and it just found a new one and is going to repeat using it, as Tesla brought native land loophole to New York to avoid the direct sale ban. Welcome back, friends. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. If you are here first time, take a moment and subscribe to our channel. Tesla is going to repeat a loophole it has previously used to open stores and service centers where direct sale laws prevent it by operating a native land. This time the automaker is doing it in New York. There are a few states in the United States that have laws prohibiting direct sales of electric vehicles to the public without going through third-party dealerships. These bans come from old laws that were meant to protect car dealerships from their own automakers supplying the vehicles. The idea is that automakers could open a company-owned store next to a third-party dealer after they have made the investment to sell and service their cars. It would be unfair competition. Now, however, car dealerships are using those old laws to prevent automakers that never had deals with third-party franchise dealers like Tesla from selling their vehicles to the public, even though it's fair competition. Tesla has been fighting those laws in many states with some success. In New York, the law still exists, but Tesla managed to get an exemption to open a few stores and service centers, even though its bid to expand it has been curtailed by the local dealership association. In New Mexico, Tesla found an interesting way to get around the direct sale ban. In 2021, Tesla managed to open its first store and service center in the state by opening inside an old casino north of Santa Fe, and it did it by partnering with the First Nation of Nembel Pueblo and opening the location of third tribal land. Last year, the automaker did it again to open a second location in the state. Now Tesla is taking the loop to New York. Syracuse News reports that Tesla made a deal with Oneida Indian Nation to build a location on their land. Here is what Syracuse News reports. The 25,000 square foot showroom is planned for a tract of Oneida Indian Nation owned land across from the International Boxing Hall of Fame at Truway Exit 34 near Canastota. It would be Tesla's first direct sale outlet in the state outside the New York City area and is expected to open in 2025. This is going to enable Tesla to expand in the state of New York without having to convince state legislators to let them sell directly to consumers without having to go through a middleman. So what do we think about this? You might think that it shouldn't be a tough ask for legislators, but it can be when dealerships are big contributors. Good for Tesla to find a solution, even if it's not the most ideal. Ideally, those laws would just not be abused to protect car dealers, who should just be willing to compete with Tesla and any other automakers that decide not to go to franchise dealer route. So what do you think about this new loophole that Tesla has found and is going to repeat using them? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, friends.